Space travel is an amazing feat for humans, and not just because of the equipment needed to get up there. The human body has adapted perfectly for life on Earth. Past our atmosphere is a dangerous and wild zone that our bodies are not meant to deal with, but somehow, humans have prevailed. With that being said, on this Sci-Five, we list off 5 incredible things that happen to your body in space. Number 5, inflating. A common misconception about space is that without a suit, a human body will explode due to being exposed to a vacuum. This is obviously not the case, however, the reality is not too far off. Your body will in fact inflate to around twice your size. This will be a direct cause of a process called ebullism. Ebullism is when gas bubbles form in bodily fluids, and is caused when the pressure in the environment is reduced. The nitrogen dissolved in your bloodstream closest to the surface of your skin will start to form into little bubbles, and eventually, these bubbles will expand. This is what causes your body to puff out. It will start in your hands and feet, eventually moving its way to the core of your body. It also occurs in your mouth and your eyes. The bubbles may begin to block arteries, which could then block the passage of oxygen to the brain, essentially starving your brain. Your lungs may begin to hemorrhage and swell out, and unless the process is stopped quickly, the tissue damage alone will be enough to kill you. Now, this is a very important issue in early space travel. In an attempt to prevent ebullism, NASA's early space flights contained a pure oxygen atmosphere. This in itself is an extreme hazard, as pure oxygen is highly flammable. This was a major factor in the ground test fire of Apollo 1 that killed 3 astronauts. NASA continued to use oxygen, but soon switched to a nitrogen-oxygen mixture. Spacesuits are set at a lower PSI than capsules or shuttles, since they still use pure oxygen. Number 4. Space radiation exposure. Traveling beyond Earth's atmosphere is a good way to learn the importance it plays on our survival. Besides holding in heat to keep our planet warm enough to be habitable, it also keeps out space radiation. Space radiation is different than the radiation we experience on Earth. Examples of Earth radiation would be X-rays or gamma rays. Space radiation is made up of 3 kinds of radiation: particles trapped in the Earth's magnetic field, particles shot into space during solar flares, and galactic cosmic rays. The rays are so fast and powerful, they will ionize the cells within the human body. Ionizing, for those who may not be familiar with the term, is the conversion of an atom or molecule into an ion, which means all of the electrons from the atom are stripped away, leaving only the nucleus. This is incredibly damaging to the human body, and in long term can cause cancer, as you may expect. On the ISS, astronauts are exposed to about 10 times more radiation than Earth. This can cause radiation sickness, which symptoms can include nausea, vomiting, anorexia, and fatigue. The unfortunate thing about space radiation is that it isn't really preventable, so anyone going into space knows full well what they're exposing their body to. However, there are ways to reduce the amount people are exposed to, and they continue to research methods to prevent it further. The issue is actually one of the biggest challenges in the mission to Mars. However, NASA says their various mitigation techniques are enough to ensure safe travel to our red neighbor. Number 3, fingernail loss. This phenomenon is referred to as fingernail delamination. This is actually not caused by the vacuum of space itself, but rather the design of the gloves used for spacewalks. Due to the pressure inside the gloves, the rubber material they are made of hardens and creates an uncomfortably stiff boundary surrounding your fingers. The use of these gloves causes painful blisters and tears around the nail beds. Extensive spacewalks that can last 6 to 8 hours can prove very damaging for the nails. It is very common for the damage to cause the nails to fall off entirely. In a study conducted on injuries reported between 2002 and 2004, 22 astronauts reported fingernail delamination. This is such a concern for astronauts that many have been reported ripping their fingernails off entirely before going into space in order to avoid the pain caused by the gloves. There is good news for those with smaller hands, however, as those with smaller hand circumferences only have a 5.6% chance of experiencing the phenomenon. This isn't exactly something you think about when you picture astronauts floating around in space stations, but spacewalks can be incredibly painful and uncomfortable, even before taking into account that they're stuck in restrictive suits for up to 8 hours. Number 2, a weakened immune system. If you can imagine, the human body did not adapt to conditions in space. Therefore, the defense system our body provides is not ready for the harsh conditions outside our atmosphere. Our immune system can be weakened due to many different factors in our natural environment, let alone outside it. In space, our system can be affected by various sources, including radiation, microgravity, stress and isolation, and the disruption in our circadian rhythm. While in space, astronauts will also interact with more microbes from themselves, other crew members, food, and their environment in general. Microbes are a bacteria that can cause fermentation and diseases. These can be incredibly hard on the immune system and can potentially lead to infections among the crew as well as contamination of extraterrestrial sites. Scientists have also found that some cell activity is depressed, which causes the immune system to not produce appropriate responses to threats. This could explain the phenomenon called asymptomatic viral shedding. This is when latent viruses such as chickenpox are reawakened in the body. To the contrary, scientists also found that some cell activity is heightened, which causes the immune system to have an overly aggressive reaction. This could explain why some astronauts report increased allergy symptoms or recurrent rashes. And number one, freezing. Finally, there's freezing to death. Despite the temperatures being minus 265 Celsius or minus 455 Fahrenheit, you won't freeze instantly. The reason your body gets hypothermia so easily when in water isn't about temperature. It's because water is a great conductor and convector. Water is really good at convecting heat away from your body, causing you to freeze faster. This is why scuba divers or winter surfers wear wetsuits, so there's a layer to prevent this. But because space is a vacuum, there is no convection or conduction, so you won't lose heat as fast. What will get you is radiation. Every human is technically glowing in the infrared spectrum. The heat is radiating at about 100 watts. Essentially, this means our bodies are constantly letting off heat. On Earth, our output is more than countered by our environment, thanks to the sun and the ground. So, here on the homeland, we can radiate as much as we want and not have to worry about freezing to death. In space, however, this isn't the case. Due to radiation, if you're on the dark side of the moon, your body could take 8 to 12 hours to freeze. However, if you somehow end up close to the sun, your body may not even freeze at all. It would burn up. Regardless, an exposed human can live for about 30 to 90 seconds in space before inevitable death. First, any water exposed, such as liquid in your eyes or on your tongue, would boil off in seconds. Quickly after that, you lose your sight. Luckily, before anything else goes wrong, you'll lose consciousness due to the oxygen being dumped from your blood. This is when your skin will start to turn blue and circulation will stop. You'll then likely die of asphyxiation. So in short, the human body is not suited to survive in space, which only makes us being there even more interesting. Thanks for checking out This Sci-Fi. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, check out my last video, 5 Mysterious Encounters with the Men in Black. And be sure to stay tuned for future Sci-Fis on all things science and science fiction.